Hey, 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 Mr. Manly here with lesson number 333 in How to Be Manly. Spring is here, and I was at a sports bar the other night when in came a mixed league team of softball players. They sat at a booth talking about the game. There was one guy sitting between a man and a woman with his arms draped around both. I figured him to be their switch hitter. But I must say, there was one striking woman there, and I thought she's got to be the DH, meaning designated hooters. She was arguing with one of her teammates that was trying to pitch her something until finally she walked over and sat down by me. Thinking I made it to first base, she said, "I'm Marjorie." I said, "Hi, Marjorie. What seems to be the problem over there?" She said, "I can't play for that team. That guy told me I can't handle a bat, can't lay down a bunt, and can't cover home." Well, after hearing this, I thought I'd cover all the bases and do so in a manly manner. If you ever find yourself in a similar situation, follow along in your manly manual, page number 333, and repeat after me. Number one, handle a bat. Why don't you try handling this bat right here? Number two, I can show you how to lay down a bunt. Come back to my place. We can lay down and bunt all night. Number three, hey, Marjorie, my home plate's open. How'd you like to cover it? Shortly after, as Marjorie bats you around and you're protecting your own home plate, as Marjorie's teammates join in and bunt you off the premises, you'll realize just what kind of man you really are. Until next time, this is Mr. Manly saying be manly and good day.
Breaking the news that's already broken. It's time for Prospector's Briefs on Rock 107.
Tomorrow is Earth Day, and I refuse to celebrate until they give wind and fire their own holidays, too. BuzzFeed News is shutting down. It's a sad day when you can no longer catch up on the latest world events and find out which Harry Potter character you are in one click. The USFL and the XFL are competing head-to-head. It's a race to see who's the first to file Chapter 11.
Prospector ruins everything. Even the news. Tune in Monday for Prospector's Briefs on Rock 107.
You hear it all the time, you know, it's just not true. Good morning, I'm Rock 107's Prospector. Yeah, people always say, there's nothing to do around here.
Nothing to do around here.
That's not true. In fact, I found three cool things going on in Northeast PA this weekend. Starting with Friday, tonight, Theater North in Scranton, Gold Dust Woman. A Stevie Nicks Fleetwood Mac tribute, Gold Dust Woman is the ultimate tribute show celebrating the legendary and beloved career of Stevie Nicks. Gold Dust Woman takes audiences into the 4+ decades of the timeless solo career of rock and roll's mystic poet and 2-time Rock and Roll Hall of Fame inductee, along with the classic songs of Fleetwood Mac. Tickets are available at the box office, which opens at 5 p.m. on show days at Theater at North and Main Avenue in Scranton, or at theateratnorth.com. Well, there's one, right? Okay, I got a second one. Saturday in Pittston, starting at 10 a.m., the Northeast PA Outdoor and Arts Festival. Celebrate Earth Day at the inaugural NEPA Outdoor and Arts Festival happening in downtown Pittston. Enjoy local food and drinks, live music, over 65 vendors, crafts, and children's activity. And the best thing, family-friendly event is free and open to the public Saturday morning at 10 a.m. in Pittston. And there, Prospector's found two. I told you I'd find three cool things to do. On Sunday, in Mayfield, Lackawanna County, starting at 9 a.m., Northeast PA's Top Ninja Warrior at the Ninja Nook in Mayfield. NEPA's Top Ninja Warrior is a ninja competition for ages 3 and up, broken down by age group, trophies and medals awarded to the top 3 placements in each age group. Test your ninja skills and be Northeast PA's next top ninja. That's Sunday starting at 9 o'clock. I told you I'd find three cool things to do in Northeast PA this weekend.
The following rant may cause you to pull your hair out, scream at the radio, punch the dashboard. Complaints should be addressed to loudmouthyambag@rock107.com.
Hey, I'm Rock 107's Prospector, and here's what has me jacked. Let's talk about roads in Northeast PA. And I'm not talking about potholes and crumbling shoulders. We know all about that.
I'm ranting about a more seasonal annoyance. Cinders. You know, the remnants from the snow treatments mixed with other dirt and stuff that collects on the shoulders of roads all over Northeast PA. Think about that. Cinders are all over the shoulders of most roads that we drive on and ride on. Yeah, because I'm a cyclist and I'm keenly aware of cinders, how much are on the roads, and the damage that they can do. I bit it hard a few years back on some cinders and tore up my leg, but good. They caused me to ride more towards the middle of the road than I would like. They caused me to go slower down hills, lest I get forced into the cinder shoulder by some unforgiving or unaware motorist. So when I'm going more to the middle of the road, I'm slowing you down in your car. I hate them. Cinders gunk up the drivetrain, reduce traction, increase tension as I ride, but that's not the only reason I hate cinders. Because, of course, in addition to being a cyclist, I'm also a motorist. And let me tell you, cinders ain't no picnic behind the wheel either. Cinders creeping from the shoulder into the travel lane can ding your paint or your windshield. Cinders creeping from the shoulder into the travel lane can cause you to slide or skid if you need to stop quickly. They're dangerous and annoying. And I get why they get put there, but I think we need to do a better job of cleaning them come springtime. Once the weather breaks, I think maintenance departments and PennDOT should be out there with broom trucks and sweepers and all that kind of stuff, cleaning our shoulders all over the Commonwealth. I mean, if you put it down, you should pick it up, right? Let's use some of the wastewater fees and taxes to pay for this much-needed service. We keep the roads cleaner and safer for all of us. Come on, PennDOT. Come on, DPW. Clean our shoulders. Maybe then it'll look better and fewer people will toss their garbage out of their car window, making it worse. I'm Prospector. I'm for the people. Who's with me? I gotta go crazy, man!
Ever see the crazy guy screaming at the wall outside the Times building?
Where does this rage come from, my son?
Tweet us with hashtag IFoundProspector and we'll come and get him.
Prospector, mornings on Rock 107. Life's pretty tough right now. There's plenty of bad news, but it's not all bad. It's time for the brighter side of Prospector on Rock 107.
A guy in New Jersey named Vincent Transfield is in the news because he recently turned 109 years old and says he feels great. He still drives, he volunteers at his local fire department where he used to be chief, and he looks a lot younger than his age. He says the secret is to stay positive, do the things you love, and drink lots of milk. He also still has an occasional beer every now and then.
Thanks. We needed that. The brighter side of Prospector on Rock 107.
Have you ever tried to turn a friend onto something you love and they're like, eh? Yeah. Good morning. I'm Rock 107's Prospector. I did my part to share the finest cuisine in all the land yesterday, and it didn't exactly land like I was hoping it would. The other day, I'm coming back from Philly with a friend. Heading home, he said, are we getting something to eat or are we going to wait till we get home? I'm like, dude, I can eat. What are you in the mood for? And he's like, something fast casual, but something we don't have back home. Ever been to Shake Shack? No. All right, great. Let's go get a burger at Shake Shack. If you've never been, it's great, quick, greasy burgers, crinkle-cut fries, great shakes, kind of like a Five Guys, but greasier. And I love it. But as soon as I told him crinkle-cut fries, I knew it wasn't going to go over well. He goes, I'm not a crinkle-cut guy fry. Really? All right. Well, whatever. We get there. I actually gave him a note. I said, we can go somewhere else. He's like, nah, we'll just go there. That's fine. I'm like, okay. We get there. There's a couple people waiting in line. So we use the kiosk touchscreen thing to order. Wait for the checks that our food got there. Great. I ordered the award-winning single cheeseburger. Seriously. Just yesterday, the website Thrill List listed the best fast casual cheeseburger in America as Shake Shack. Beating Five Guys. They want a fastie. That's how good this thing is. He gets the double. Well, you know, look, it's not award winning, but probably not going to be bad, right? We wait, get the food, and I dig in. I mean, I devour it. I start actually having acid reflux issues because I was eating too fast. I had to slow down. It was a problem for me. He eats his meal like a grown up, like an adult human, but he doesn't love it. It didn't work. I wanted him to be like, dude, thanks for turning me on to Shake Shack. This is the greatest thing in the world. I wanted him to be a Shake Shack evangelist, you know? Instead, he was like, maybe we should have waited till we got home. Ah!
What's a yambag?
A fool, an idiot, a blockhead, a dunce, or an ignoramus, you know, a dullard, simpleton, or a clot, nitwit, dipstick, pea brain, mouth breather, or cretin.
It's now time to announce the winner of Prospector's Yambag of the Week, as decided by you at rock107.com.
Here are the nominees.
Nominee number one.
What's the dumbest drunk thing you've ever done? Bet you can't top this. A 36-year-old guy named Joseph Moulton got hammered last Saturday, broke into a police station, and pooed on the floor. It happened at police headquarters in Naples, Florida, and that's not all he did. Here's how it went down. First, he scaled a fence outside, got into an unlocked cop car, and hung out there for a few minutes. Then he hid behind some bushes until no one was looking, found a hose, shoved it under the door, and turned it on. The lobby ended up flooding with an inch of water or so. So somehow, no one noticed any of this. Then, once he was in the building, he took a shower in the locker rooms, put on a police uniform and bulletproof vest, tossed a $1,000 police radio into a toilet, and defecated on the floor in the woman's bathroom. He was gone before anyone realized what happened, but they were able to identify him because it turned out he'd left his wallet and ID behind. They found it in the cop car he got into outside. It turned out he was so drunk he didn't remember doing any of it. He's facing charges for burglary and grand theft.
Nominee number two.
This might be funny in a movie, but you can't do it in real life. An employee at an elementary school in Oklahoma got arrested for blasting a kid in the face with a dodgeball. Now, it's not clear if he is a teacher or not, but he was sitting off to the side while a dodgeball game was going on and a ball hit him. He claims the kid did it on purpose and refused to say sorry. The kid claims it ricocheted off another student and was just an accident. Either way, the guy allegedly responded by beating the kid three times in the back, the leg, and the face. That one knocked the kid's glasses off. The kid told the principal called the cops, and for what it's worth, other students backed up the kid's story. The guy admitted he threw the ball to teach the kid a lesson, and he said they refused to apologize, so he paid them back. Also, he refused to say he was sorry either. He's facing charges for misdemeanor assault and battery.
Nominee number three.
It's amazing that anyone could be this dumb, but the parody site rentahitman.com just caught another idiot. The site started as a joke back in 2005, but then emails started coming in from people who thought it was real. So the guys behind it started reporting those people to the cops. It helped arrest more than 30 people over the years, and here's the newest moron who fell for it. Last week, the FBI arrested a 21-year-old in Tennessee named Josiah Garcia after he got in touch with Rent a Hitman to see if they were hiring. He's a member of the Air National Guard, and back in February, he submitted his resume and asked about obtaining employment as a hitman. He said he was looking for a job that paid well and where his military experience could come in handy. Adding, quote, "What can I say? I enjoy doing what I do. So if I can find a job that's similar to it, such as this one, put me in, coach." Police led him on for 2 months to make sure he wasn't joking. A quick Google search would have told him the site was fake, but he never checked. He said he'd be willing to kill for as little as $2,500. He agreed to do a hit this month for $5,000 and asked if he needed to take a photo of the dead body as proof. He was arrested last Wednesday after accepting the money.
Nominee number four.
Whatever happened to just playing hooky the old school way? A 21-year-old woman in New York named Jaylene Mota was recently hired by Buffalo Wild Wings. But she didn't want to go into work last weekend, so she hatched a really dumb plan. She sent text messages to random people claiming someone was going to shoot up that Buffalo Wild Wings location. She said it'd be a massacre and lots of people were going down. She knew people would believe her and warn the restaurant because, unfortunately, this kind of thing happens all the time in America. But she should have known they'd also call the cops, who could easily trace the messages back to her. Jaylene was arrested and is looking at up to 5 years in prison.
And the winner is
the idiot who applied for a hitman job at the parody site rentahitman.com. Trust me, the voting was close. There were so many great yambags this week, but that's your yambag of the week. Keep it here for all the nominees for Prospector's Yambag of the Day, weekday mornings on Rock 107. Be sure to catch us live weekdays from 5:30 to 10 a.m. on Rock 107 or online at rock107.com or the Rock 107 app, a free download for your Android or iPhone. Subscribe to the podcast on Apple Podcasts, Google Podcasts, Spotify, Stitcher Radio, or wherever you get your podcasts so you never miss Prospector's Prime Cuts.